Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you how to set up a hammock. I have a Amazon hammock by Buyers by Maine, and I found these online. They're called the Amazonia's Micro Rope. It's just a quicker way to set up your hammock. It has little pieces of aircraft aluminum that are drilled in certain spots, and you hang the ends of your hammocks off of that rather than hanging it off of paracord or hanging it off of ratchet strap or something like that. It pretty much takes the guesswork out of setting up a hammock. So this is a Brazilian style hammock. It doesn't have it's not ropes or like a bridge hammock where it has a stiff end. It's actually pretty much completely controlled by your own weight and allows you hammock. It has a mosquito net, which is really awesome, especially in the summertime, that you can hang and keep it well off your head. And then it has these two loops that go out to lines, and then it eventually goes out to the hammock. The best way to keep these from tangling, which will happen if you have this style of a hammock, is have a very small light carrier. I think I got this off a water bottle or something like that, but it's good to have this because you can keep the two ends together and keep it from twisting, which is, trust me, a huge pain in the butt. Undo, especially if it's dark, you're getting set up for the
hammock. Alright, so I'm going to show you how to set this up. So, the micro ropes, it has a loop on the end that you wrap around the tree, and then you put the tail end through that. And then it goes out to this piece of aluminum. It goes down, wraps around, makes a loop, wraps down one more time, goes in through this loop, and then comes out, and this is the tail end. So depending on how far your trees are apart or the length of your hammock, this is all adjustable. And so I have this adjusted to the width of these two trees, and what's so awesome about this system is, losing my camera there, all you do is take the loose end, the loop of your hammock, put it under this loop, wrap it around one side, wrap it back over the other side, and it's a little bit difficult, so it's, you know, it's nice and tight on there, and then you pull, and your hammock is all set up. And I like mine with a little bit of slack in it. A lot of people like theirs, you know, really, really tight, or they like theirs really saggy. The thing I don't like about it being too tight is you have a chance of ripping your hammock. Especially with something like this one has a mosquito net on it, you can rip your mosquito net right off, and that's the last thing you want, especially in the summertime or, you know, for future use. Or you can rip the actual nylon of it. And if you have it too loose, then your back is really sagging. And the point of the hammock is to have a nice straight back to have a good comfortable sleep. But, you know, if you have too much sag in your hammock, it's not going to feel all that nice. So that's how you set up a hammock with this micro rope system. There's other ways to do it. You could set it up with loops and paracord. You could do an S-ring with a paracord. I've seen people use climbing rope to set up their hammock. That's a bit overkill. Also with climbing rope is it tends to stretch, whereas with something like this you want it to be a bit more static. So I really like this micro rope system. You could also use, I've seen people use ratchet straps, and the advantage of a ratchet strap are it's like webbing tape. And so when you wrap it around the tree, it's not gonna harm the tree as much. The only thing with ratchet straps is they tend to be pretty heavy. So I really like this micro rope system because it's nice and light, but it's strong. These ropes, I'm pretty sure, can hold between the two of them up to 1,000 pounds. And this hammock can hold 250 pounds. There are other Brazilian style hammocks that it's just fabric. There's no ropes here. Those systems work just fine as well. This is just the one I purchased when I started hammocking, and it's worked really, really great for me.
And this is about how I like my hammock. It's not too tight, but it's not too loose. And how do people think about getting hammock is, oh, well, I'll just put one leg up. I'm already off balance. So the best thing you could do is you want to almost set it up so you're falling back and you're sitting back into it, but you do it very slowly. So I'm just sitting on it. The edge of the hammock's right here, and the rest of it is actually, I believe, flopped over. Let me sit up real quick. There we go. So I'm gonna sit in. I'm uphill, so I'm gonna walk forward a little bit and let it settle so it's back in the middle, and then put my feet up. But when you lay in a Brazilian hammock, it's not like any other hammock. You lay at an angle. So if I lay straight forward and back, see, I have this space in the middle of my feet. In the middle of the night, that gets very uncomfortable. So if you want to be comfortable throughout the night, lay at a diagonal. And this will keep your back straight. It'll keep your feet just a little bit elevated. And there's no bed that compares to how comfortable a hammock gets, especially in the middle of the night. The only thing with a hammock, and this is what a lot of amateurs will realize, is your butt gets cold. And so the science behind that pretty much is just think of a bridge. Why a bridge freezes first? It's because there's air passing under here as well as air passing over. So your butt gets cold because it's the same thing as when a bridge freezes, it just gets colder. So being at the low point, your butt's going to be the first thing that gets cold. So how to counteract that is some people put a sleeping pad under them. You could put a comforter under you in the hammock. The only thing with that is it'll compress the insulation and you'll still get a cold butt. So there's something made called a underquilt. They're not the most affordable. They're pretty expensive, but big old squirrel over there. But if your sole camping method is to use a hammock rather than a tent or a tarp or something like that, I would definitely invest in an underquilt, and you'll stay a lot more comfortable in cold-ish, more temperate temperatures than summertime, because real hammockers aren't limited to just summer. They like to use it all year round. So if you invest in an underquilt, it'll help keep you a lot more comfortable throughout the year.
But yeah, that's how you set up a hammock. Please don't hesitate, hit the like button, leave a comment if you like, or if you have any questions, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.